Dear viewers, welcome you to this video. In this video, I'm presenting about set of operators used in C programming or in C language. C supports rich set of operators for the mathematical calculations and logical analysis or logical processing. Let us see what are all the operators used in C programming or in C language. An operator is a symbol used to perform either the mathematical operations or logical operations in your program. Operator is a special symbol that tells to the compiler to perform mathematical or logical operations. C programming language supports rich set of operators that are classified as follows: arithmetic operators to do all the arithmetic operations, assignment operators, auto increment and decrement operators, or it is termed as unary operator, bitwise operators, conditional operator, relational operators, logical operators, and special operators. Let us start with understanding what is the meaning of arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are used to do simple arithmetic operations. There are five arithmetic operators used in C programming. Let us see one by one. Plus is used for simple addition or summation. Minus is used for simple subtraction or finding the difference of two numbers. And star is used for calculating multiplication. Slash symbol is treated as a division operator. It is used to find division of two numbers. It provides quotient as the result. There is one special operator, it's percentage symbol, but technically it is called as modulus operator or modulo operator. It's used to calculate remainder after the division. The remainder of two numbers we can find out with the support of this percentage symbol. Let us see with an example. Using variables. C is one of the variable, resultant variable. This is to receive the result of the operation is equal to A plus B. A plus B are, it is a process, it's a calculation. A and B are variables. When these variables are involved in the process called addition, then it is called as operands. A and B are termed as operands. When these variables are involved along with the operator in the processing or in the calculation, then A and B are termed as operands. Originally, it is termed as variable. When it is involved in the calculation, then it is termed as operand. Simple, operator and operands together only process or calculate something. C is equal to A minus B. C is equal to A into B. C is equal to A slash B. It's for finding the division of these two numbers or finding the quotient of the division process. C is equal to A percentage B. It's to find the remainder of the division process. Let us see with an example or using the numbers. Let us assume that 10 plus 5 are the values substituted to A and B. Then 10 plus B is equal to 15. 10 minus 5 is equal to 5. 5 into 10 is equal to 50. 10 divided by 5 is equal to 2. It is a quotient. Whereas 5 remainder 2 or modulo operator 2 results with 1. 2 into 2, 4. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. Remainder is different from quotient. I hope you know the fundamental difference between quotient and the remainder. Now, set of conditions or set of rules to use division and modulo operator, we need to understand, it's more important. Division operator slash allows both of the data type, float data type and integer data type, or it allows float variable and integer variable. Whereas the modulo operator allows only the integer. Modulo computes a remainder when one integer is divided by another. Modulus operator cannot be used for float type variables. It permits only the integer data type or integer variables. Please keep it in your mind. With this, lot of gate examination questions are as to test your basic understanding. Now let us start looking into the C program, sample program, how to use question and how to use reminder. Start with hash include. It's a pre-processing section. Hash include is the predefined keyword used to include the header file, stdio.h, standard input output header file, int main. It's the starting line of the program. It is mandatory to use the main program in your C programming. It is of two data type, int or void, the written data type. Whenever there is a word followed by open and close parenthesis, this is example for function. Every function must have the data type, written data type. Flower bracket. In near future, we'll be discussing what is the meaning of function, how it works, how we need to write function, how we need to handle function. These all we'll be discussing in the forthcoming sections. Right now, let us focus on how to use the quotient operator and reminder operator. Flower bracket starts with the programming. Int, the very first part of the program after this flower bracket is declaration section. Declaration section has two major components. One is the data type, another one is variables. Each and every variable must be separated with a comma and must end with semicolon. Here, integer is the data type used int. The keyword is int. Keyword in the sense predefined or reserved word in the computer. We cannot change those meaning or semantic. We cannot change the usage, that is syntax. We must use as per the compiler or the language designer. So it's designed in the early stage of C language invention. So we have four variables, four identifiers. One is dividend, divisor, quotient, reminder. Dividend and divisor are the input variables to get two inputs to do the calculations, quotient and reminder. Quotient is a variable, output variable, which receives the quotient after the division process using slash symbol. Reminder is the variable which is used to receive the result after the modulo operation. That is reminder after the division process. When you do division, 4 divided by 25, how do we do 4 into 6 or 24? We will subtract 1. This 6 is called quotient. This 1 is called reminder. This 4 and 25 are two numbers involved in the division process. Whereas 4 is called divisor, 25 is called dividend. So what is used here is called quotient. What we obtain here is called reminder. That's it. This during childhood days, you would have done this calculation. The same philosophy we are using in this program. Now, to obtain the first input, you are giving the printf statement, enter dividend, and using scanf statement, you are scanning the first variable, or you are getting the input for the first variable or dividend. Percentage D is used as the control string or format string because dividend is declared as integer. Declaration means reserving memory space for the process. We reserved memory space for these four variables of the data type integer. Now scanf, this is used for getting the input for the one variable. This is used to obtain the input for the variable dividend. Next, printf, enter divisor. Scanf is used to obtain the input for the divisor variable. Now the computation starts here, finding the quotient. Now quotient is equal to dividend divided by divisor. One variable divided by another variable. Now let us imagine dividend is 25, divisor is 4. Then quotient will become 6. Now let us compute the remainder. Remainder is equal to dividend percentage symbol divisor. Now calculation got over. Computing quotient, computing remainder, both have got over. Now we need to print or we need to display the answer. printf quotient is equal to percentage d comma quotient. So the path is to be displayed should be put it in the double quotation. The variable what we want to display is to be separated with a comma. The value of this variable is transferred to this control string percentage d. Quotient is declared as integer, so we need to use percentage in the printf statement. Similarly, printf is used to print reminder, the value of the reminder. Hope you would have understood. So this is the output for this program, enter dividend. This is how your output screen or during the execution it will look like. Enter dividend, your computer will ask to you, you need to feed this input 25. Then enter divisor, your computer will ask to you, you need to feed the input 4. After the calculation, your computer displays these two lines with the quotient equal to 6, with remainder is equal to 1. Now, program to do all the arithmetic operations. Let us see. There are 3 variables declared. A is equal to 9, B is equal to 4, C. Hope that you would have understood what is the meaning of hash include std, standard input output header file. This header file is essential to include in your program. Only then you are permitted to use the printf statement or printf function for printing or displaying something on the screen and scanf function. And many more. A very basic necessity of doing program is getting input and displaying output. Now let us see, the main program starts here. Open bracket, int a is equal to 9, b is equal to 4, c. Instead of scanning the input, obtaining the input during the execution time, we are making it as fixed. We are assigning 9 is equal to a, 4 is equal to b. That's it. Now c is equal to a plus b, 9 plus 4. It is going to become 13. Print of C value. Just print with the double quotation. A plus B is equal to percentage D slash N, comma, double quotation, comma C. Then C is equal to A minus B. This is the statement to calculate subtraction A minus B. Then print the C value. Every time you are printing C, the value is displayed on the screen. You are permitted to alter the content of the C. There is no harm in it. No need to have different variables to receive the results of each and every arithmetic operation. Then and there, the moment it is calculated, you are printing. Suppose you are doing all the operations first, then you start printing, then you must have separate variable for each and every operation. Otherwise, it will be overwritten. Now, C is displayed here. Now C is free to use. C is equal to A into B, print of the result. C is equal to A slash B, print of the result. C is equal to A percentage B or remainder B, print of the results. Return 0, close bracket. See, A plus B is equal to 13. This is the output. For this program, there is no input. We made it as a fixed input to this variable. A, though it is variable, we assign some value to the variable A as 9. Then it becomes fixed. Throughout the program, the value of A becomes 9. B is equal to 4. So throughout the program, the value of B becomes 4. For this program, there is no input at all. It does some calculation based on the value set to A and B, and it produces the output on the screen. Now, let us see the explanation. If we look at this program, nine divided by 4, it must be 2.24. Instead, the result is only the integer value 2. Why is that? Let us see the explanation for this. Plus, minus, star computes addition, subtraction, multiplication respectively, as you might have expected. Because the answers are absolutely right for these three. Whereas fourth operation, division operation, the expected result is 2.25, but the obtained result is 2. Let us see what is the reason. why it gives different result. It is because both variables A and B are declared as integers. Then the output is also integer. The input which are all involved in the process are integer, then output must be integer. The compiler neglects the term after the decimal point, 0.25, it neglects or it avoids. The modulo operator percentage computes the remainder. A is equal to 9 is divided by B is equal to 4. So 4 into 2 is equal to 8. Then the remainder is 1. Because percentage operator accepts only the integer, the input involved in this operation both are integer, the result is also right integer, the result variable is also integer. Now let us see how to make this as a correct answer after the division process. Suppose how division operator works for mixed data type. Suppose A is equal to 5.0, B is equal to 2.0, C is equal to 5 and D is equal to 2. Then in a C program, A divided by B is equal to 2.5 because both of the operands or both of the variables are assumed that it is declared as a floating point variable. Second one, either one of the operand is floating data type, then also the result will become float because float is a superior data type than the integer data type. So the superior data type will become the dominant in the resultant variable. So A divided by D, where D is the integer, A is the float variable. Then C divided by B, C is the integer, B is the float variable. Either dividend or divisor, any one of the variable becomes float variable, the result will become absolutely right. Suppose C divided by D, if both are involved the integer data type, then result is also integer. We can't expect the value after the dot operator. Assignment operators. Now we are looking into next set of operators, assignment operators. Assignment operators are always used to assign right hand side value to the left hand side variable. LHS equal to RHS combination is to different variants. Here simple assignment operator equal to, but there are different variants of equal to operator. We are going to discuss the next slide. There are six assignment operators are used. Simple, single, equal to operator is used for simple assignment, LHS equal to RHS. Whereas plus equal to is used for arithmetic operation and to receive the value. Minus equal to is used for doing arithmetic operation subtraction, after the subtraction to receive the value, etc. Similarly, star equal to, slash equal to, percentage equal to. We would have seen in the previous slides all the five arithmetic operators. Now, assignment operator, variant of the assignment operator, how it looks is, use all the arithmetic operator followed by the equal to symbol. Plus equal to, minus equal to, star equal to, slash equal to, percentage equal to. What is the meaning? Let us see. Through this example, I hope you can understand easily. Simply giving A is equal to 15. The value 15 on the right hand side is assigned to left hand side A. Whereas, how to use this operator? It's a little bit tricky. Initially, if you understand carefully, it becomes easy for the further understanding. A plus equal to 10. That means here only one variable is involved. A is equal to A plus 10. Before plus symbol, whatever the variable is used, that is going to become operand, that is going to become resultant variable. It will involve in the process. Also, it will involve in receiving the result of the operation after the processing. Let us see the second one. A minus equal to B. A is equal to A minus B. A involves in the process of operation and A also receives the result of the operation. The next, A star equal to B. It is expanded as by the compiler. We no need to expand. A star equal to B. It is equivalent to A is equal to A star B. A is involved in the processing as well as A is also involved in receiving the result. A slash equal to B. A is equal to A slash B. A percentage equal to B. A is equal to A percentage B. Let us see with some programming usage. Then you might be understanding in the better way. Look at this program demonstrating the assignment operator. Hash include stdio.h main function open bracket. We have two variables, int a is equal to 5 and c. A is fixed, assigned with 5. Now we are doing with a simple assignment, c is equal to a. What it means, a is the variable having the value 5, that 5 is transferred to c. Now both are having same value, a is also 5, c is also 5. Now print of what it would print? 5 naturally, because what is there in A is given to C. Next, C plus equal to A. See, this is single line comment. What is the meaning using comment? In this program, it is explained the meaning of C plus equal to A semicolon. Here C plus equal to A is internally by the computer or by the compiler expanded like this. C is equal to C plus A. C involves in the process of addition. Also, C involves in receiving the result of the addition process. Now, print of C. C prints 10 because the value of A is 5, value of C is also 5. Now, C is free to use for the another process. Now, C minus equal to A. The meaning of C minus equal to A is equal to C minus A. What is the meaning? C is also 5. C is 10 now. Because in the previous case, C became 10. Now C is 10. 10 minus 5. The result will become 5. Now C prints 5. Now next step. Remember, in this point, C has the value 5 again. Now C star equal to A. A is fixed, it is 5. Always A is fixed and 5. Now 5 into 5. C is equal to C into A. 5 into 5, it becomes 25. Now C has the value 25. Now in the next step, C slash equal to A. The meaning is equal to C slash A. Now the value of C is 25. Divided by A is fixed at 5. 25 divided by 5 is equal to 5. The answer is 5. The quotient. Now C prints 5. Now remember in this point C has the value 5. Now C modulo operator equal to A. A is fixed always. It is 5. Now 5 modulo operator 5. 5 divided by 5. The remainder is 0. Because exactly 5 is cancelled by 5. So the remainder is 0, written 0. Hope you would have understood. Now let us look at the different set of operators called as bitwise operators. Simple ampersand symbol or and symbol, piping symbol. And on the computer, the piping symbol will be there. You need to find out. The piping symbol will be vertical line having two discontinued line or without discontinuous. This piping symbol is combined with slash symbol on your laptop or computer. Cap symbol. This is called cap symbol. Tilde symbol. Technically, ampersand or piping symbol. Cap symbol, tilde symbol, greater than symbol, less than symbol. Now, what is the meaning of this bitwise operator? These bitwise operators are used in performing bit level operations. Bits, there are only two bits available in the computer world, either 0 or 1. 0 is 1 bit or one is 1 bit. It will work on the bit level operations. Always, though you give input in the integer number, the given number will be converted into bit forms. After conversion of the bit forms, only then the process will start. Let us consider two variables A and B. A has the value 25, B has the value 20. Once if you give input A as 25, B as 20, your computer involves in the very first process of translating or converting this integer number into its equivalent binary number. The binary value of 25 is 11001. The binary value of 20 is 1010. Now in this case, given integer is translated or converted as bit form. Bit form always will have either 1 or 0. The following table, let us see what are all the bitwise operators available. Here I termed the technical terminology of each of the operator. But what is the meaning, how it performs, what it does, each and every operator, let us look in the forthcoming slide. AND operator or ampersand, single AND operator, which is used for bitwise AND. The way to use in the C programming is A AND B. One, otherwise it is zero. I will explain you each and every process with an example bit later. Right now, let us understand what is the meaning of each and every operator. This piping symbol, it is called bitwise OR. The way to use is before and after, left side and right side of the operator should have two operands. Like similarly, AND operator also should have two operands, left and right, before and after. And next symbol is cap symbol. It is called technically, or the purpose of cap symbol in the C language is to calculate bitwise XOR. A cap B. This is to calculate XOR operation. Next, tilde symbol. Tilde symbol, it has only one operand. We need to be careful. These three operator has binary, or it has two operands. It has only one operand. What it does is, it does the complement or negation of the bit. Let us see how it does. So we need to use tilde symbol followed by the operand or variable. The next operator, double less than operator. The purpose of this double less than operator is to calculate left shift operation, bitwise left shift. This operator has two values or two variables, A left shift 2. 2 signifies 2 times it needs to shift, and next bitwise right shift. Remember, wherever this sharp edge is there, that edge you remember, sharp edge left. This side the sharp edge on the right, so right shift operator, something like that, Q I am giving. So double greater than operator is technically called bitwise right shift operator. So how we need to use variable, double greater than symbol, or bitwise right shift operator, and followed by 2. This 2 says how many times it needs to shift, normal shifting. So 2 signifies 2 times shifting. With this bitwise operator introduction got over, let us see how to calculate this all with an example, how to convert given the number into binary form, and how the operation AND, OR, XOR, and bitwise complement and shift operator. There are two shift operators, left and right shift operators, how it does with an example. Keep watching.